নানা শাস্ত্র বিচার নৈক নিপুণ সদ্ধর্ম সংস্থাপক লোকানাং হিতকারিণোতি ভবনে মান্যৌ শরণ্যা করু রাধা কৃষ্ণ পদারবিন্দ ভজনা নন্দী নমাত্বালিকো বন্দে রূপ সনাতন ঋগযুগ শ্রীজীব গোপালকো বন্দে রূপ সনাতন ঋগযুগ শ্রীজীব গোপালকো গৌড়ীয় গোষ্ঠীপতি শিশিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাঠ শিল জীব গোস্বামী পাদ ওয়াজ দ্য লাস্ট রাজপাত্র অব বিশ্ব বৈষ্ণব রাজসভা ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাঠ শিল জীব গোস্বামী পাদ ওয়াজ দ্য লাস্ট রাজপাত্র অব বিশ্ব বৈষ্ণব রাজসভা Actually, what Prabhupada wanted to speak by this word? What is the duty of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava? What is the actual duty of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava? That should be clarified first. The duty of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava is there to get control over whole Vaishnava society so that any one of them cannot do anything which is unusual, not good. Whole Vaishnava society should be regulated by a fountainhead. You can remember that Swarup Gosai was the fountainhead of all Gauriya Vaishnava society. That was actually indicated by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. You are responsible for whose Vaishnava society. You will have to take care of them. That was the indication given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to us. So we all always respect Sri Swarup Gosai regarding any Siddhanta Vichar, what to do, what not to do. All fine judgment regarding Shuddha Bhakti we can get from Swarup Gosai through disciplic succession. Swarup Gosai gone, but still we have with us our Guru Varga, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Jiva Gosai Pad gone. Eternally they are present, they are going to regulate us. So actually it is the duty of Vaishnava Rasabha to regulate the whole Vaishnava society in such a way that they can be directed to one-pointed devotion. There should not be any desire, separate desire, like Anna Vilasita Sunyam Jnana Karmadi Anabridam Anukulena Krishna Anusilanam Bhakti Ruttama. All our Rupanuga Guru Varga, they are showing one-pointed devotion. They're all one-pointed. Ekayan Paddhati. Those who are foolish, they cannot understand why there is diversified Paddhati there. But actually those who are Rupanuga devotees, they can find a system. They can find that it is totally regulated and directed to through one channel. It is called Ekayan Paddhati. You can remember those political leaders, they are sometimes speaking, we should channelize the whole youth power. Those are young men, their energy should be regulated through one channel. One channel for the development, total development of this society, human society. Not that some political leader or some notorious people can take advantage of their energy. They can bring some young men and use them wrong way to get some advantage. This is present situation. I have no right to ask any devotee that you message my leg. I have some headache, you message. in my whole life, I never, I can die, but still. But I think they are making some chapati for me. They are my Guru Varga. I think this way. They are my Guru Varga. How I can speak them? I have no right. They are all servants of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Guru Varga. I have no right to give some special order to them. This way, actually, Ekan Paddhati is only possible if there is any fountainhead. You can remember when all our Goswamis, they are all gone, even after Jiva Goswami Path, Narottaman Raghu, Srinivasaji, Ramchandra Govira, all when they gone from this world, leaving us alone, Raghunath Das Goswami, everybody gone. Then you can remember, you can go through scripture and find Chaitanya Bhagavat, you can find the situation of this Vaishnava society. People like to lead their life fancifully. They think it is bhajan. Chaitanya manavishtam sthapitam jena bhutale, kena bhutale, by Guru Varga, by Jiva Goswami Path, Rupa Goswami Path. They are actually parshad. Not that everybody can become a parshad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. After doing bhajan, they can get siddhi, vastu siddhi, then they can. That's a different thing. But not that they are all we can say they are coming here in the material world, acting as acharya. They are all parshad. No. All wrong. You can remember about Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, you can remember Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj writing most scientific thing. Exactly, if somebody was not lucky to look at Prabhupada, what they can look with this material light? Still I am speaking. Still, if they have their, you know, power, I mean, capacity, by the grace of Guru Vaishnava, to go through that Prabhupada Stakam, Prabhupada Dasa Stakam, they can have the clear picture what Prabhupada is. The character of Prabhupada in the form of Bani, totally represented by Sridhar Goswami, which is quite impossible. What is what? We like to know. We have not seen Prabhupada. Sometime it was asked to Santo Goswami Maharaj. Maharaj, we are illiterate. We are not educated. We like to know how Prabhupada was looking like. Santo Goswami Maharaj thinking for some time. Well, I cannot give any example. But still I am trying my best. Whole world, if you choose some beautiful lady, two or three, all over the world, if you select, topmost. And if you, so many beautiful ladies you put in one room, hall, and in between you can put Prabhupada. Not touching, but still, separately. If anybody coming first, they are going to look at Prabhupada. I was surprised to see the example. Maharaj, how you, yes, yes, yes. I need not explain big way, so you will have to remember. So power and so like one, like sun glowing. So many beautiful ladies, but if somebody coming first, he can look at Prabhupada. No chance to look at any lady. So now you can realize. There is a condition. Now actually, about Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Potitodharane Kritavesha Jyatim, you can remember, no? Potitodharane Kritavesha Jyatim, yeah, no? But everybody is speaking, he has taken initiation from Prabhupada, so he is our Guru Varga, he is actually Parshad. So no, this Siddhanta is wrong. But how? You are insulting? I am not insulting. I am speaking Siddhanta. The reason for why Prabhupada has taken sannyas. Why? To deliver all bonded soul. The reason for why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was bound to take sannyas, what is the reason? Mahaprabhu himself told. I came here to deliver them. But they misunderstand me. They think we can beat Nimai. Who is Nimai? We can beat heavily. We can beat Nimai heavily. Mahaprabhu said, oh my God. I wanted to give them remedy, find some solution. But when they think they can beat me, they then that bondage become doubly tight. Oh, what is the solution? Then I will have to take sannyas and go door to door, said those people, those who are having some, you know, some different attitude from me, maybe some envious attitude or some angry attitude, who can say? If they say, if they can see me in sannyas base, they can have some, oh, yes, taken sannyas. How we can fight with him? This was the mood Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already told. I will have to take sannyas to deliver them. Now, potitodharanekkitoveshajatim, when it is written, but you say, oh, everybody parsad. If everybody parsad, then why Prabhupada coming in the material world? My point you understand. Those who are going to take harinam and sannyas or diksha from Prabhupada, if we can think that way, that all they are parsad of Prabhupada, then what you mean to say? Prabhupada coming here in material world not to deliver a new bonded soul. That you mean, na? What do you mean to say? That means Prabhupada coming uselessly and through Harikatha, Kirtan, his gigantic personality, not going to deliver even a single soul. Because you say they are parsad. Parsad mean? Parsad mean total troops with full truth, Prabhupada coming and going away. Then no bonded soul was delivered. So wrong Siddhanta. Parshad mean? Eternal Parshad mean? Gauranga Mahaprabhu coming with eternal Parshad and going away. Sometime eternal Parshad, they are coming much before Chaitanya, Supreme Lord coming. After Supreme Lord gone, they are coming. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone, that time came. Abhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, they are all parsad. So, this is wrong Siddhanta actually. Now, up to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, we have seen how to maintain Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. Never mind. Up to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, we have seen how big way, how exclusively Prabhupada wanted to maintain Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. Those who are Sahaja, they are not going to cooperate with us. Whom to blame? There we have no headache. Because they can fight with us. They can fight with us on red cloth issue, on sannyas issue. They always fight regarding scarred thread. I already give answer. They are Sahaja. They have no brain. Huh? They have no link with Guru Varga. That's why they are having no knowledge about Siddhanta. So actually, up to Bhaktivinoda Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, we have seen how to maintain Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. After that, still our Guru Varga doing, but it was glamorous way that time. Glamorous way, to the point. Not only that time it was a system that those who are doing exclusive bhajan, serving Gurudev, Prabhupada, Guru Varga, Prabhupada watching. And in Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava, it was the system that Prabhupada giving them honor. Follow what I mean to say. A giving honor to them. Why? Mahapadeshak, Mahapadeshak, Upadeshak. Follow? Different kind of title Prabhupada used to give. This is not material title, don't think that way. Don't think that way. Because if we cannot recognize, if we cannot give honor to devotees according to their activity, seva, and if I develop envious attitude, then I am not at all Vaishnava. If you have some special quality, I must, you know, see it. I must give honor. Though you are less interested, because Vaishnava less interested to take any honor. But still, recognition is the way. If any society, you see a quality, I mean the any special quality like education, proficiency, devotion, seva, if you're going to ignore, have some envious attitude, then the Vaishnava society can collapse down. Even in material world, even in this material world, government always watching all over the our country. Who is having what special quality? Always watching. And government in a year calling them, giving some special title. Follow? Like Padma Sri, this, that. On world basis, this system is always there. Nobel Prize, this, that. So, we should recognize. You have quality. For on political ground, I am going to lose my honor. If I want to project your quality, then I can go down. So, I can kick you out of mot. This is the present system. If my godbrother is there, then I am not going to get that much honor. He is very qualified. He can speak nicely. He can do kirtan. So kill him or throw him out. One devotee of Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, a foreign devotee, used to do kirtan so nicely. Even Indian devotees I have not seen. So nice kirtan. A feeling, you know, how he very sad he gone from this material world. Until and unless our society is going to give honor to those appropriate person, then society is bound to break down, collapse is a system. So Prabhupada was very careful. Baba always to give proper honor to proper person. You do. A designation. That's why Vishnu Vaishnava Rasva was organized very scientifically by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. And I think after Jiva Goswami Pad, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur was the fittest personality to organize. You can deny it, but I don't care. You can deny it, you have your liberty. But I don't care. He is the topmost personality to organize Vishnu Vaishnava Sarasva the best possible way. Why? It was the motto of Prabhupada in his own life. Every fraction of second, Prabhupada thinking about the good of this human being, bonded soul. All the time, every fraction of second, Prabhupada thinking how I can do some good for them. So that they can grow Krishna consciousness. If we can find that kind of mentality with all, you know, devotees, those who are acting as acharya, then we can say, for my personal honor, I can ignore somebody, I can throw somebody, I can do the, I can give, you know, initiation to somebody who is not at all qualified. But you want to prove that Maharaj, my Gurudev is very merciful, that's why I give. No! He's a demon. You are just giving initiation to give honor. Because he has some total social status, position, he's a big man in human society. So you are initiating him. You should not give initiation to him. If you at all want to give honor to Jiva Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad, not that way. Then the system can break down. Bhaktivinoda Thakur 160 years back crying on this ground. We should think over and again to systematize the whole system. Who is going to follow whom? All have some separate dogma. My Gurudev, your Gurudev, your Gurudev. Hari? Your Gurudev, his Gurudev, his Gurudev, all separate Gurudev, scattered. But previously, all our Guru used to think, I have no personal identity. I can identify Nityananda Prabhu and successive order, I can honor to Guru Varga. Jiva Goswami, who am I to take honor? That was the system. Now, Srila Jiva Goswami Pad, as Rajpatra of Vishnu Vaishnava Rasbhava, was always responsible to get control over this Vaishnava Siddhanta, Acharan, everything. And all the time, every fraction of second, Jiva Goswami Pad was busy to think over and again about some issue which is very sensitive. Regarding Parakya, Sakya, there's big fighting, I already told. Actually, I like to touch first because today is the appearance of a Jiva Goswami Pad. I like to touch, I'm not going to go details because you know. Because always Guru Vaishnava appearance day, disappearance day, there is ontological aspect and morphological aspect. We are not going to discuss about that, he took birth there, he took birth there, he was grown up there. This is one kind of history, but still, we like to discuss about Siddhanta, Vichar. What is the Siddhanta Vichar of Jiva Goswami Pad? That is the... Somebody is speaking, big writer, darshanic philosopher, they are writing, Jiva Goswami Pad took birth 10 years after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur and other important personalities, they are putting some evidence, giving some evidence, which is more practical. Jiva Goswami Pad took birth 10 years before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's disappearance. This is more practical, according to his own writing, but not. Is the fallacy. Actually, Sanatana Goswami, Rodhpa Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, Raghunath, they are not putting any date. Even big, Prabodhananda Adi, big, Loknath Goswami, even while Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami compiling, they request, don't put my name there. Don't put my name there. Loknath Goswami requesting, don't put my name there. Please don't put my name. I have seen the move of Guru Varga through our Guru Varga. We have the chance to realize the mood of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And also, last Srila Bhavan Goswami Maharaj. One day some question was put before him. But he told, I want to die unknown, unseen. Why, Maharaj? I like to die unknown, unseen. Who am I? This is the actual attitude a Vaishnava should have. For that, if I say, I cannot speak Harikatha, Harikatha can get some fame and name from me, you are idiot. Vaishnavi Patishtha Tatekaranishtha Tahana Kalile Ravive Raura. It is Vaishnavi Patishtha not going to touch your heart. Why you are contaminated your heart? Why you are going to take responsibility for that? Vaishnavi Patishtha mean all Patishtha given to me, I should pass over to my Guru Maharaj. My Guru Maharaj can pass over to Prabhupada. Prabhupada can pass over to Gaurakishore Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This way, all successive order, we can find all honor and respect going unto the lotus feet of Nityananda Balaram. Ultimately, unto the lotus feet of Radha Rani. I am not going to take any honor, any pranami, anything. I am not going to pass any remark. If I speak anything unusual, which is not just in line with Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur Siddhanta, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, any new Siddhanta you are going to speak, which is unusual, all responsibility can go on you. It is your responsibility. But if I am going to remember all Siddhanta of Guru Varga, then I have no responsibility. I am acting like a postman. You know the postman? Postman has only responsibility to take all letters and go door to door. In your name, some letter coming. So I have my responsibility to post a letter, go to you. We have one letter for you. Take. And if something dangerous written in their letters, some nice news written there, some dangerous news, that postman is not responsible. Postman saying, he opened the letter, find something unusual. He like to beat postman? No. Why? Postman is not responsible. Postman is a deliverer, going to deliver that letter to you only. Why you are going to beat him? This way we are all peon. Prabhupada speaking, we are going to bear all responsible letters, everything already coming from our Guru Bharga, one by one to you. Open the letter and show you, please see man, see madam, see sir, is written there. I have no, don't be angry with me. It is written by Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Why are you becoming? And Prabhupada is writing according to Bhaktivinoda Thakur or, you know, Jiva Goswami Pada, Rupa Goswami Pada. Why are you becoming? This is a system. So, any new Siddhanta which is unusual, I am going to speak, all responsibility can come unto me. I have to suffer for that. But if I have no vanity, no false ego, that I am a preacher, I have no vanity, I am a preacher, who am I to preach? If I am in line, Prabhupada can sit here and speak Harikatha. I am a speaker. He is speaking on the speaker, can amplify the word. Actually, that word originally come. So you see, actually, it is more practical to understand. Because they are writing so many books, sometimes they forget to write the date when the book was compiled, completed. They forget. Raghunath Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Bhargava, they sometimes forget. Even they are putting some note at last, which is most confusing for you. They are very clever. Sometimes, like, you know, Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad, when Radharada Sudhanidhi totally completed, at last shok, he is putting some confusion. Mayabad arko. There is Mayabad inside my heart. Like scorchy sunlight. Very paining. Now I am free by the mercy of. Then everybody, your big, big acharya and Radha Kunda say, hey, he is actually that Prakasananda. He become Rapodhana. No. So many documents we have. No, not at all. Why writing? Is one kind of dainya. Come on, man. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself speaking that way, in Dakshin, in South India, in Madhvacharya Pit, when Mahaprabhu asking that, could you please advise me about Saddha Sadhan Tattva? Those Acharya, they are speaking all preliminary thing. Mahaprabhu, after that hearing, keep silence. Oh, I know, you look at me and see I am Mayavadi sannyasi, so you deprive me, I know your mood. You are not speaking actual Saddha Sadhan Tattva to me. You see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking so nicely, so that they cannot feel pain. Mahaprabhu speaking, I know, you have seen I am Mayavadi sannyasi, so you are going to deprive me. You are not speaking about actual Saddha Sadhan Tattva. For that, if some foolish man can understand that Mahaprabhu actually Mayavadi, then what that? What is that? Many Guru Varga writing this way. Many Guru Varga, I will show you. Kishnudas Kubiraj Goswami writing, I am lower than the insect staying in stool. So what? We can pass judgment, Kishnudas Kubiraj. Come on, he is giving identity, that he is as the lowest creature in this material world. He is even lower than the insect we can find in stool. We can pass this kind of judgment? Whereas Gaurakishore Babaji was speaking, I am the lowest creature in this material world. Who going to see me? You can do one thing. After my death, you can tie my leg with rope and, you know, pull on ground like dog. One dog and fox when become there, then they tie on leg and pull. You can pull me on ground of this Dhamma Antipati, throw in Ganga. Oh. People, they are so foolish. That Gaurakishore Babaji was giving his last desire that when after death you have to, we have to tie a rope and pull. Vimalaposa Saraswati was like lion. Who you are? Idiot number one. Then inspector of general came, all problem took place. After that, when Prabhupada started speaking one by one, they are all gone. You touch the transcendental body and see that you are not doing any urban association. Do speak. You want to identify yourself as the disciple of Paramahansa Gaurakrishna Babaji Maharaj? No! I am the only disciple of Gaurakrishna Babaji Maharaj. I have no God brother. Who is God brother? Who is God brother? You are fully speaking. You are God brother. Who is God brother? Who is not going to follow my Guru Maharaj? How I can say he is my God brother? You can guide me. You can see, Maharaj, you are not following your Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj, this point you are not completing. Then I can try. I am not disciple of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. If I fail to follow my Guru Maharaj, maybe some defects is there. I am trying to reconcile. I am day by day trying to overcome some problem. But that's okay. But totally, I am not following Guru Maharaj and right away. I am the disciple. You see, you can give me honor. I am the disciple of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami. Many devotees. This is not the system. On the contrary, you will have to behave, you have to do bhajan such a way so that people become interested to know who is your Guru Maharaj. Are he is speaking this way? Maharaj, who is his Guru Maharaj? Who is it? People should be interested. Same thing, same thing. I am not making any new Siddhanta. Prabhupada told. When somebody told that Prabhupada, we cannot see Radha Govinda properly, that gate is very small. Prabhupada said, come on, we cannot see Radha Govinda with his eyes. On the contrary, we will have to behave, we have to do bhajan in such a way, Radha Govinda become interested to look at me. That is called bhajan. I can see Radha Govinda. Then Radha Govinda become a matter of enjoyment in my life. I can look at Radha Govinda, how nice Radharani is, how handsome Govinda is. Idiot number one. You cannot touch this kind of fine Siddhanta if you are not doing bhajan. If you reach one, if you can go inside the room of a big rich man, and if you enter the room, you can find Maharaj, there is so nice picture, Gajendra Mokshan. Here, there, nice, oh, so nice devotee. You are foolish number one. You have no knowledge about Gaudiya Siddhanta. You have no knowledge. There is nice Radha Govinda picture in wall. Is one kind of enjoying mood is there with that man. That's why you want to enjoy the picture of Radha Govinda. You want to enjoy. It's not devotional mood is there. This kind of fine Siddhanta, almost rare in this material world. Only you can know by the mercy of Keshava Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada. Only. Only and only you can know. Is one kind of enjoying mood. You putting, no, he's not devotee. Foolish you. You can misunderstand. He's not devotee. You want to enjoy the picture of Radha Govinda. Oh, so nice. Huh? If you have seva mood, any situation you can approve. Any situation you are put into, you should approve. Well, it is done by Nityananda Prabhupada, Guru Maharaj. So this kind of fine Siddhanta is almost rare, you see. So, you see, it is more authentic, more practical to feel, to understand that Jiva Goswami Pad took birth 10 years before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's disappearance. All Guru Bhargava writing this kind of, you know, humble attitude. Prabhupada speaking is some big philosopher speaking. Arey Maharaj, he is identifying himself in such a dirty way. He is a fallen soul. So I have no time to follow his philosophy. He himself identifying, he is a fallen soul, even a lowest creature. Huh? Prabhupada said, no. The more you are going up and up, the more you can develop humble attitude. I am nothing. You can come and kick me. You can throw me. Who am I? Even material scientists, those who are having practical idea about this creation, like Einstein, Newton, or philosopher, big writer, they are, you know, Kant, they are expressing their heart. When we look at the sky, galaxy way, we find, I'm helpless. I'm helpless if I look at the sky, stars and planets there, how they hold on there in their respective position in this infinity world. Who am I? I have gone through a scientific fiction. There I know that even those who are living in different planet, alien, those who are staying in different planet, like our human being, no? They are also like human being. They are called alien. Though scientists speaking, those alien, if coming here in this material world, they cannot discover us. I mean, why? They cannot see, we are so teeny. Yes, you are laughing. We are so teeny, he cannot see. He can go through a paddy field, you see, like, cannot see. Like the mosquito, like, you know, ant, they cannot see. It's really so, yes, their body is so. Even in this material world, rhinoceros, you see, if you look at, oh my God. Huh? And Chaitanya Charitamrita, Timingil. Timi. What? Huh? Timingil, why? Timingil. I mean, they can, like tablet, you know, one muscular, gone. Ready? How big is? All big, tightening, everything can go like mosquito inside. What is this? Yes. So this respective comparison should be there. I mean relative. This relative world must put some impression inside your heart. Because otherwise you cannot think. You can think, I am nice inside this room, Maharaj, no problem. Only you are busy with some problem happening here, inside this room. Are Guru Varga thinking about the problem all over the world. How to save them, how to save them. Even he like to kill that devotee, still the devotee want to save him. It's the mood of Guru Varga. You are busy with some small problem inside your room, like ants and mosquito. But Guru Vaishnava always like Jeeva Goswami, they are busy with full problem. How the whole human society running towards fire. How to save them? How to protect them? How to give them some advice? I know, they are not going to obey me. But still, it is a Siddhanta retaining Chaitanya Charitamrita, you know? Yano sa Krishnad vimukho shadaiva adharma sila sa sudukhitasa anugrahayeho charantinunam bhutani bhavyani janardanasa. All the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, deputed delegation, they are coming here to help us to cut material bondage and go. Why you are here? This way, the name of Jiva Goswami Pada is topmost. Why? After Rupa Sanatana gone, Jiva Goswami Pada was very, very anxious about us bonded soul. First of all, I like to clarify the point I wanted to discuss. So it is more practical to understand Jiva Goswami Pada took birth 10 years after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 10 years before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's disappearance. Because in some grantha, we discover that while Rupa Sanatana and Anupam came to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first, it's not appropriate. Actually, they are eternal prasad. How I can speak, they came to meet first? What to do? In this lila, it is first. They are eternal person. But in this Leela, they came for the first time to meet with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu night time in a simple civil dress. That time, that Jiva Goswami Pada was very lap, small. So we have information. So Jiva Goswami Pada could see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And another calculation, if you do, Jiva Goswami Pada is going to leave body 85. If I'm not doing any mistake, I think so. You can check up. So 85. And up to 20 years, after 20 is going vanish. Vanishment gone. Externally renounced order. I mean gone outside. But before that, you was very clever. Because Rupa Sanatan gone. And Anupam also gone. So Jiva Goswami Pada in childhood always crying day and night, no protection. Big protection mean? Rupa was there, Sanatan was there, all gone. I'm alone. After that, nobody allowed that small boy to go. Then ultimately was very clever. He took decision. I'm going to Navadvip to learn, to get education more. Because that time, Navadvip was, the topmost place in the whole world. I cannot say Navadvip is the Oxford of India. It's derogatory to speak that way. I would say Oxford is a Navadvip. Oxford is a Navadvip. I cannot speak that way. It is derogatory. Because Oxford is a material place, Navadvip is translated. How I can compare? I should speak very scientifically, without any Siddhanta Virodh. So somebody is speaking, Navadvip Maharaj was the next, Oxford of a whole world, in the whole world. I am very sorry to hear this thing. You should speak different way. All people, those who are really interested to know Vedanta, Upanishad, logic, Nay, they must come, they should come, they must come in Navadvip to get a degree here. Otherwise, who is going to give recognition? Follow. So you see, that time that was the situation. So Jiva Goswami Pada was very clever, took advantage of the thing. Actually, I will have to go to Navadvip to take education more. Well, those family members said, well, you can go. But actually, day and night, Jiva Goswami Pada staying at room. Every now and then, Jiva Goswami Pada going faint in the name of Hanita. It is written. You can go through Bhakti Ratnakar, written by Madhumati Sakhi, Narahari Prabhu. You can find. It is written there. Every now and then, Jiva Goswami Pada going faint. Oh, Nita, oh, go back, fall down. It's so beautiful looking, like one, it's beauty I cannot compare with one prince. I cannot compare. Any people, when Jiva Goswami Pada with tears rolling down his cheeks, walking down street, everyone looking at you. Who is he? It is Vaikuntha picture. Everybody looking at him. So nice, with ecstatic feeling, tears rolling down. Everybody looking at Jiva. Who is he? Is prince or something? No. No prince. He is a Vaikuntha picture. Jiva Goswami Pada is transcendental picture, you see. This way, you see, Jiva Goswami Pada ultimately reaching Navadvip. Why? It was one kind of indication. Because when you know, first time when Rupa Sanatan was bound to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that time Nityananda Prabhu was also there. So when Jiva Goswami Pada come here, first duty, he was bound to meet Nityananda Prabhu. Jiva Goswami Pada was lucky enough to meet with Jiva Goswami, with Nityananda Prabhu. Then Nityananda Prabhu bless him big way. Bless him. Because without the blessing of Nityananda Prabhu, it is one kind of Siddhanta. Even Raghunatha Goswami, who is the eternal Parsad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the eternal Parsad of Krishna, but still, it was a system. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove this way. Hey! Sthir vaiya ghare jao naho batul. Krame krame paaye loke bhavashindu kul. Yo, go now at home. Gradually people can get the end of this material ocean. You can also get this kind of chance today or tomorrow. Don't be busy. Go now at home. Raghunath crying, I come to take shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prabhu, send me at home. Prabhu, send her. Go. Because without the keeper of Nityananda, Gauranga is unable to accept the Jivatma. Without the keeper of Radharani, Sarvashakti, we cannot get bhakti. I already discussed so many times also. Big thesis, one kind of thesis. Scientific document from long time I can, if all devotees they bless me, I can try to discuss this point. Very follow. So for Raghunath also same. Not that for Raghunath the rules was broken. No, go back. And when Nityananda Prabhu giving full kippa, Daichira Mahasav, you can know. That time actually Nityananda forecast. Nityananda speaking well. Raghunath crying. It is my desire, heartiest desire, to get the seva of Chaitanya Chandoga's lotus feet. Nityananda bless. Well, you can get the lotus feet of Gauranga. Not only that, you can get some exclusive seva under the guidance of Sarup Gosai. All forecast. Nityananda speaking. Same thing happened. When Raghunath going there, really so. He was lucky enough to take the guidance of Sarup Gosai. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself saying, Sarup, you must take care of him. I am giving this to you. Sarupen Raghu. Because in my, you know, Parsha, there is so many Raghu. Haridas also. Choto Haridas, Baro Haridas. And Raghu also. Raghu Jugau. Raghunath Bhatta and Raghunath Das. So, special keeper. Then, Raghunath Das is getting same keeper. Same, actually now Nityananda going to give full keeper on Jiva Gosai. Nityananda, not only that, Jiva Gosai path, was lucky enough to get the guidance of Nityananda about Dham Parikram. Navadip Dham Parikrama was done. Nityananda himself taking. You see, Sakshat Balaram is coming here and guiding. Oh my God, Nityananda guiding himself. Come, Jeep. This is a place where Prabhu used to play that way. This is a place. And Jiva Goswami Pad rolling down on ground and shedding tears. How ecstatic feeling, lucky, after everything over, Jiva Goswami Pad giving special order to whom? Jiva Goswami, Nityananda Bhagavan. All, you know, all your previous, you know, ancestor, those who are, you know, Raghunath, Roop, Sanatan, they all gone to Vrindavan by the order of Prabhu. So it is your specific place, you must go there. But first of all, but prior to that, you will have to go to Varanasi. Why, Prabhu? Varanasi? You have to go to Varanasi. You have to go to Varanasi. There is one disciple of Sarvam Bhattacharya, Madhusudan Vachaspati. Why, Prabhu, I can go? Yes, you have to go there. You have to go there and take lesson from him. All Vedanta, everything, Bhagavad Siddhanta. Well, by the order of Nityananda, Jiva Goswami Pad was bound to go to Varanasi. When reaching Varanasi, taking the kippa, Vishwanath, everything else should be there. Because Mahaprabhu also taking darshan of Vishwanath, what to speak about you, everybody, I also. So you see, after that, when reaching the lotus feet of Madhusudan Vachaspati, Madhusudan Bhagavan looking at him, is something special here. Well, allow him to stay and take lesion there. Whenever he started giving lesion, you see, he's a gigantic figure. He's a not ordinary boy. So he's Vidyaval. His knowledge is so deep. Bhakaran, Alankar, everything done before. What to speak about? Baladev Vidyavasan also. Bhakaran, all like, you know, dust. Done before. But here people, if they are giving 15 years to go through Panini Vyakaran, they can cry, Maharaj, it's impossible. Panini Vyakaran, 15 years gone, still cannot write properly. Yes. So special merit you need to understand everything. So Madhusudan Vachaspati could very easily realize, oh, I'm lucky to get such a you know, student. Oh, nice. He went on giving lesson one by one. After listening one time, finish. Within a short interval, he finished all education, Veda, all Gaudiya Siddhanta. Now, we are crying all Vaishnav society. We have no place in this material world, big universe, where we can get and take the lesson about Gaudiya Vedanta Siddhanta. At present, this is the situation. In BHU, Benaras Hindu University, you can go. You can find they are reading Ramanuja Vedanta. Because sometimes some question, I've also been there for some reason to search something. I talk with them. They say, Maharaj, who is going to read Gaudiya Vedanta? Because one professor, he need to pay 80,000, 1 lakh. If there is no student, how we can arrange? They are speaking this way. They are speaking. They are speaking, actually, those who are Gaudiya society, they are so lucky. They are so rich. They are so rich. But they are so foolish. Nobody there to go through Gaudiya Vedanta Siddhanta. There is no student, Maharaj. How we can arrange one professor? It takes 1 lakh rupees for one professor. 1 lakh 10,000. How we can arrange? If there is sufficient student, nobody interested. Only we are ready to pass lecture. My memory is very good. I can memorize some sloka, everything, and try to put. You see, I am the disciple of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. You see, my proficiency. Who care, man, your proficiency? Who is going to listen to your lecture? We are less interested to hear him. We have no time to go to hear your lecture. We want to know. We want to get some direct feeling from you. If you have, from your Guru Bhargava, if you have any direct feeling, that you can share with me. I am less interested about lecture. There's thousands of people. You open internet, big lecture are there. Somebody speaking. Somebody speaking on Vedanta, somebody on Bhagavata. Oh, big honor. But actually, who is going to enjoy the full kippa of Bhagavatam? Who is going to enjoy the full kippa of Vedanta? Can you show me? I already told you one small story, practical. It is not actually false story. It's, I told you now one day, you can remember. One day there was a big, you know, Shava. There was Vedanta, all big Vedantists came. And one sadhu also came, very humble sadhu. Then they are sitting in chair, like star. One by one, they are giving explanation on Vedanta theory. After that, the Sabhapati, chairman, requesting that sadhu, you can also speak something. Maharaj, I am actually poor man. I have no education, nothing. I am doing bhajan only. But still, you are here. We like to hear some of your realization you can speak. What to speak? That sadhu started speaking on Vedanta Siddhanta. And all big, big stars of Vedanta, they gone mad. Just now that sadhu speaking, I am not educated properly, I know nothing about Vedanta. He is speaking the topmost secrecy of Vedanta. Even we don't know. After the sabha was over, they stand up and come in front of sadhu. We like to know what kind of degree you have taken on Vedanta. No degree, nothing. No degree? No. But then how you get that kind of realization, which is almost rare? He shook down his head. Never mind, I like to put one question before you. If you never mind. Well, you can put question. When you started reading Vedanta, what was the mood with you? I like to know from you. You are the stars of Vedanta philosophy. I like to know, let me know, what was the idea, what was the conception, what was the desire when you started reading Vedanta, took admission. We wanted to start our education with a mood, we can become a big Vedantist and explain Vedanta in very nice. So you are. So you are at present. So you can be a nice philosophy in Vedanta. What you wanted to get from Vedanta, Vedanta already approved that thing. Bancha kalpadruvasya. Vaishnava in front of Vaishnava, if you serve with some different mood, you can get it satisfied. Original thing you cannot get. You should be very clever. We say na bancha kalpadruvasya. Bancha means wishing tree. We have seen in the life of Guru Maharaj, many people come here and say, maybe here they get good. No! They are coming in front of Guru Maharaj to get some advantage of business, this, that, some position, rank, Guru Maharaj giving them. Even Prabhupada also. Prabhupada also. Prabhupada knowing he is having some attraction for money. Before leaving body, Prabhupada, one box, full of money, full. That time lakhs of rupees, maybe at present crores, I don't know. Baba speaking, try to get that box from that place. Before living body, I am not going to speak the name because I have no mood to criticize anybody. Call that Prabhu in front of me. He is taking control of Gauri and everything. Before living body, Prabhupada giving this box. You keep this box with you. I am very sick. He opened the box and found lot of money. Huge amount of money. Prabhupada wanted to cheat him. With that money, he wanted to procure special land in his name. Those Vaishnavas, they are very clever. Don't try to make fool of any Guru Vaishnava. If you want to make fool of them, then they can cheat you. Big way. Don't try to. Try to express actual humble attitude. Then you can come out successful. Try to express your humble attitude. I am really fallen soul. Who am I? I have nothing. Then you say, but I wanted to speak. What I want. So that Vedanta, that's sannyasi with folded hands speaking. Never mind. You started Vedanta with this mood that you can become a Vedanta star. So you are. And with what mood you wanted to? Well, actually, I took lesson from my Guru Maharaj a little bit. Guru Maharaj is gone and I am also not educated. You have, before taking Vedanta, degree, previously you have so many degrees. But I have no degree. I am almost... So you have taken only... preliminary relation from your Guru Maharaj, yes. By the mercy of Guru Maharaj, I developed this kind. Oh my God. So I always, whenever I read Vedanta, whenever I used to read Vedanta in front of my Guru Maharaj, this kind of mood was there with me. I always used to pray Vedanta, take Vedanta and put on my chest. Oh Vedanta, try to bless me so that I can get some realization. Oh, Vedanta, I like to get some direct realization. Please grant. That is my desire, whole life. Then those stars crying and speaking, really you are. Actually, you are Vedantist. We are not Vedantist. This kind of direct feeling is not possible until and unless the full keeper of Vedanta. I also told one day, one big Pandit in Orkha, one place in Rajasthan, big, is coming in front of king and speaking, I have taken lesson degree from Varanasi this day. Oh king, I like to explain Bhagavatam big weight in front of you. That king was devotee, not so-called devotee, nice, but still nice. He was favorable for Guru Vaishnava. He is speaking, Maharaj, you are not going to enjoy full kippa of Bhagavatam. What do you say? I can speak all commentary, everything. I am sure that you are not enjoying full kippa of Srimad Bhagavatam. Please you go, never mind. Go through Bhagavatam, try to get. Actually, then you can come. I can hear. Then the Pandit, he was feeling insulted. Ah, king speaking this way, I am big Pandit. I have Vedanta degree Bhagavatam. Oh, well, gone. Again gone through Bhagavatam, again coming in front of king and speaking. King, now I again gone through, I do the detailed scrutiny and now I can explain Bhagavatam. King with folded hands speaking. Still today you are not enjoying full kippa of Bhagavatam. Please you go and read Bhagavatam again. Again that Pandit gone, feel insulted. Third time when he came, he was disgusted. He said, I am not going to... Okay. That Pandit was very big way, insulted, big way. He think, king always speaking this way, but I have so many degrees. Vedanta, Bhagavatam, this, that. Oh my God, I can go away. He gone away to a lonely place at the bank of Ganga. And with Bhagavatam in hand, he is reading Bhagavatam with tears rolling down his cheeks. Bhagavatam is reading. Very nicely. I was also mad to read Bhagavatam, lonely, nobody there. Who is going to hear in Suryakunda? Not even a single man, like mad, reading. Follow. Now after some time, the king taking information. 1 year gone, that Pandit not coming, you can take information. What's the news about him? They took his mother, family member say, he's gone somewhere, we don't know. We have no knowledge about the whereabout of that man. We have no knowledge about the whereabout of that man. Yeah? You don't know? Your family member? Well, no, you secretly gone somewhere. Then the king started searching, where gone, where gone. He sent some messenger here. Then some of them coming and giving message, Maharaj, that Pandit gone mad. Mad? Where you find? At the bank of Ganga, he is in a very small place, he is reading Bhagavatam. Where is? Let me go there. The king gone there. King gone there, watching from distance, he is reading Bhagavatam and shedding tears. The king coming and praying prostrated Dandavadan to the lotus feet of that. Pandit and speaking, Maharaj, never mind. Today I have the chance to hear Bhagavatam from you because today you are enjoying full kippa of Srimad Bhagavatam. Now I realize you are enjoying today full kippa of Bhagavatam. If you realize Bhagavatam means Krishna Himself. If you can enjoy full kippa of Bhagavatam, then you have right to recite Bhagavatam properly. Because Yad Vaishnavanam Dharam is the property of those Paramahansa Vaishnava, not my property, not an instrument to earn money. Those kind of restriction was there at the time of Jiva Goswami Pad. And late, as was the system with Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. A system. One incident I can speak, that time actually, one day, Prabhupada coming in library. And Prabhupada asking, actually, Prabhupada coming into library and asking, hey, Bharati Maharaj gone? Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj. Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj gone for path. They request him to go there to do some Harikatha, speak some Harikatha there. He already gone. Some devotee, yes, just gone. Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj just gone. Then Prabhupada asking, with which book Prabhupada asking, with which book Bharati Maharaj gone? They saying with Srimad Bhagavatam gone. Why? Chaitanya 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 Chaitanya, everything there. With which book he gone? With Bhagavatam. Prabhupada asking. Actually, we Gauriya devotees first will explain the kippa of Gaur Nityananda. He should have taken this book. Bhagavad is okay, no problem. But we want to explain the kippa of Gauranga Nityananda. That is the problem at present. We are facing so much problem. Why is the problem coming? We have new information about the kippa of Nityananda and Gauranga from right person. In books, so many things written. Who is going to read? Follow. So Prabhupada used to say, like Jiva Goswami Pad. At the time of Jiva Goswami Pad, so restriction was there. I think at the time of Prabhupada, much more restriction was there. Under the guidance of Jiva Goswami Pad. Much more restriction. You cannot do this, you cannot do that, you cannot... Now at present we see, those women, Matajis, they are going to give garland to Acharya. I never heard this. Matajis, they cannot give garland to any Acharya directly. They can give this mala to somebody, Brahmachari. But we see. Directly. Nowhere it is written. It is like Sahajya. Nowhere. This kind of. So many instructions we can get from Prabhupada, you see. So this kind of strict regulation was there at the time of Prabhupada under the guidance of Jiva Goswami Pad. But now, Jiva Goswami Pad was very careful, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was very careful, even Bhakti Siddhanta was very careful. Kesava Goswami Maharaj was very careful. If something wrong can kick you, I heard from senior devotees. One day Kesava Goswami Maharaj from his bhajan kutir coming out, he is going to some place outside. From temple bhajan kutir, Kesava Goswami Maharaj is going outside for some seva. Kesava Goswami Maharaj coming outside bhajan kutir and walking down the corridor and, hey, where from this song coming? Somebody is there. Maharaj from this place. Kesava Goswami Maharaj gradually reaching that place in the temple itself. And Kesava Goswami Maharaj could discover one brahmachari and one man working, they are playing radio and one song going. Kesava Goswami providing one kick on the radio, it became like Chanachur, scattered. Eklathi, scattered, broken into pieces. Hey, where are you gone? Huh? So late, I sent you to Krishnanagar? Maharaj, we went there to some mission, next mission. Why? We took prasadam there. Kesava Goswami Maharaj, so strict. So I don't like to touch this point, it's so heavy. So if you, it is at a time, if you are going to get bhakti, then at a time you can get. For material thing, you can grow detachment. At the same time, you can get attachment from. Not that fast you can get attachment, then no. It's an automatic factor. First you can feel, you know, after that you can. Bhakti, parashanu bhava, viraktir, annatra, at a time. Bhakti, parashanu bhava, viraktir, annatra, choisho, triek, kalaha, prapadda, manasho, khu, tushti, pushti, anughasham. Simultaneously you can grow. If you are going to get bhakti, you cannot make fool of Kesava Goswami Maharaj. Kesava, look at you. Really bhakti or something like drama? You can realize they have some x-ray. So simultaneously you can get. So Jiva Goswami Maharaj was the last Vishwa Vaishnava Rajpatra was very careful about us, so that nobody can misguide us. If anybody is speaking wrong Siddhanta, anybody speaking wrong Siddhanta, doing wrong, it was a system. The whole worship society can call him, you come. Why that day you are doing this thing? Why you have done that way? Then I beg for pardon. Then we are giving you next opportunity. Don't try to break. And from Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu not going to give any chance. Any chance. Chotori Das, what mistake done? Oh, what mistake. Live forever. At present, Brahmachari and Sannyasi all can take Mataji and backside of bike and run very nicely. Who is? Yes! I am sitting in Vyasasana. They cannot fight with me. This is a system. So who can show honor to me? Who care, man, you are Paramahansa? You have taken white vest. Who is going to honor you? If there is no character, nothing, no behavior, no Vaishnavadikas is there with you? Who is going to give you honor? So Prabhupada speaking in Bhagavad, is Shastra, it is written, it is called Beshopo Jivinaha. Those who are Beshopo Jivinaha. Beshopo Jivinaha mean those who are taking Besa to earn money and put in bank and secure their life. This is the system. But this Besa is not for this reason. Not. So Jiva Goswami Pad was so careful. After Rupa Goswami Pad, after Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami gone, Jiva Goswami Pad was the sole responsible person. Not only that, be careful. Raghunath Das Goswami, our Prajan Tattva Acharya, he was crying at last time. Crying at last time. He is saying, I can take darshan of the lotus feet of Jiva and then I can leave my body. Can you think? Raghunath Das Goswami crying and speaking. Last moment while going away, I like to take darshan of Jiva Goswami. I like to take darshan of the lotus feet of Jiva and then I can leave my body. Not before that. So you can sing the glories of Jiva Goswami. Not only that, all over the world, Jiva Goswami is the topmost philosopher. This title is nothing. This title is nothing. No amount of honor is just sufficient for Jiva Goswami Pad. What honor I can give to Jiva Goswami Pad? Any amount of honor and respect is just not suitable for Jiva Goswami Pad. In the history of this world, even we heard from Guru Varga or Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya came. It is written, I can show you. It is written, Jiva Goswami Pad is not less than them. It is written. Come on. Jiva Goswami Pad not less than them. Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya. Even Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to establish Achinta Vedavetata in a very scientific way, through which Jiva Pad wanted to give us more purified form. Huh? Even more than Ramanujacharya, more than Madhvacharya. They are okay. But when Jivapad going to represent Achinta Vedabhaya, on a thing, Jivapad with humble mood speaking. Vriddha Vaishnavai. I am under the guidance of Vriddha Vaishnavai. Hey, Kritham. Those are Vriddha Vaishnavai. Vidya means senior Vaishnav. Like Jiva, Madhvacharya Adi, especially Madhvacharya. Because whenever Jiva Goswami wanted to represent something special, he was bound to take the help of Madhya, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already told we are Madhya Gauri Sampradaya, so this way. Even going to break this Siddhanta, Ramanujacharya Shakti Siddhanta. And Madhvacharya actually only they believe 100%. Vigraha is 100% same with Supreme Lord. There is the secret thing. So Jivapad was bound to represent so many Siddhanta Vichar. One by one, if I go on speaking, I can go mad. I cannot speak that much. After Rupa Sanatana gone, first privilege we have that Jiva Goswami path digest whole Panini Vyakaran. Digest whole Panini Vyakaran. Panini Rishi was doing bhajan, astuary and finances for a long time. Panini was doing bhajan long time. After that, Shankar Bhagavan came in front of him. Shankar Bhagavan is bound to come in front of him. Hey, what do you want? I want to get full knowledge about Vyakaran, Shabda Shastra. Okay. Shankar Bhagavan bless him. And with Damru, one instrument is there. Shankar Bhagavan playing this Damru. Shankar Bhagavan just taking this instrument playing. Dig. Now I speak all secret formula of Vyakaran. By the mercy of Shankar Bhagavan, Panini could realize. There's some indication, the sound, through which Shankar Bhagavan giving indication of Vyakaran, full. Like shortened, you know, big lecture given, in shortened I can write in this five line. Then from that indication, Dumru, special rhythm was there when playing. I give an indication about Vyakaran. Now you go. By the mercy of Shankar, Panini started explaining Vyakaran. Following the sound. After that, so many Vyakaran. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu following Kolab Vyakaran. Kolab Vyakaran by Kartik, you know Kartik, the son of Durga. Hey? Kartik, Kolab Vyakaran. Kartikeya. That Kartik giving Vyakaran to somebody, I don't like to explain. It will take big time, long time. Kolab Vyakaran given by Kartika. By Mahaprabhu actually. Ananta Param Kila Sabda Sastram. And originally all coming from Supreme Lord. Eh? All coming from whom? Ka, ga. Where from coming? From Narayanudbhuta Varnakramaha. Narayanudbhuta Varnakrama. From Narayan all coming. Don't think it is a matter of joke. All coming from Narayan. Narayan Udbhuta Varnakramaha. From Narayan coming. Now Jiva Goswami Pada system is given ninth evolution. It was one kind of evolution. Jiva Goswami Pada thought if one man going to read Vyakaran, Panini, 15 years, 20 years, your life is very short, he can die. And Shankaracharya also speaking that way, na? Eh? What he can do? Shankaracharya is crying. Huh? Shankaracharya speaking, Vyakaran not going to save you from your death. Vyakaran can help you get the meaning of, provided you are inclined and to Lord Vishwa Ghat Guru. Huh? So last time Shankaracharya speaking, at last moment, Vyakaran not going to help you to cut bondage and go. Shankaracharya. Ma kuru dhano jano jovana garvam harati nimeshad kalo sarvam. This slok and another slok proper. There it is written. That Vyakaran not going to save. This is separate. So this way actually you see Jiva Goswami Pada first wanted to systematize this Vyakaran so that people not going to lose their time. Because Vyakaran, but Jiva Goswami Pada putting this is called Trivikram. This is, you know, Vaman. Making formula, small, with all these alphabets categorically. And giving them name, one name. This is Trivikram. This group name Trivikram. This is Vaman. This. After that, memorize how to apply. Any devotee want to read, you know, Harinam is a Vyakaran, is full of Harinam. Whenever you read the formula Vyakaran, you have to speak Vaman, Nishinga, Varaha, you are sick. And no, you are not going to miss your time without the name of Bhagavan. So, Jiva Goswami first. Is unique. All over the world, research going on, how he developed this kind of Vyakaran, how systematized this. And Panini also writes some formula, Maheshya Sutra, Maheshyar. Maheshya Sutra, Mahadev, from Maheshya Sutra, these, that, meeting so many. So now the speciality that when Rupa, Sanatana all gone, then Jiva Goswami Pada was bound to send whom? Srinivasajo, Ramchandra Gobriya, Narottama Thakur, with all the philosophy for preaching purpose. Because all those three are the disciple of Jiva Goswami, Shikha Guru, giving lesson. Srinivasajo is a disciple of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Follow? Narottama Thakur is the disciple of Lokdas Goswami. And you know that disciple and the guru of Samananda, you already know. This way, but still, they are taking actual secret lesson of bhajan from Jiva Goswami Pada. After that, Jiva Goswami Pada bless them and give them order with this whole full treasure. You can go and preach all over the world. First, they started moving towards Bangla. Why? It's the most sensitive place. Sensitive place there. They started preaching. Narottama Thakur gone to extreme west, east. And our Srinivasajo little bit Rarkhetro, little west of Bengal. And Samananda Babu took birth in Dharanda, Medinapur. He took charge and some is called east and south zone. Big way preaching done. Not only that, Samananda Prabhu was so powerful. Samananda giving order to Rasikananda Prabhu. Rasikananda giving, you can go mad. Samananda Prabhu there, Rasikananda there. Rasikananda disciple there. Samananda Prabhu giving order. Hey, give him order to give initiation to him. Disciple of the disciple. He can give initiation to him. What kind of power they have? They gave big initiation and power was propagated. If you are cheater, then power cannot come inside you. If I am cheater, then Guru Maharaj cannot give power to me. But Guru Maharaj can give. I cannot accept that power. That's the main problem. After that, Jiva Goswami Pada sending, in gist I can, because there is big. After that, Jiva Goswami Pada writing so many things. All those sandarbhas, you know, so many. Six sandarbhas. And also after that, you know, Karma Sandarbha also, gist. After that, he write so many tikas of Brahma Sangita, so many books he writing to help us. We are very lucky because seventh Goswami Bhaktivinoda Thakur helping us to understand their deep philosophy. You can find some ambiguity. It's so complicated, you cannot understand. You should have big knowledge about Shastra, Vyakaran, this, that. Otherwise, how you can understand? Jiva Goswami writing so many things. One or two examples I can give now about how Jiva Goswami was 100% dedicated soul unto the Lord was Rupa Sanatana. So many people, they are speaking all rubbish against Jiva Goswami Pad. They want to prove that Jiva Pad was not at all in line with Rupa Pad. And how can you speak that way? Many times I speak that way. Jiva Goswami Pad was so careful. When Rupa Goswami Pad writing Rasamrita Sindhu, and Jiva Goswami Pad, you see the tremendous love for Guru Vaishnava. I told na Srinivasacharya just one word you can remember. The antidote, unless you have tremendous attraction for the lotus feet, onto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, you cannot come out successfully. Balavan adaro yasso na sad guru padam buje. Balavan adaro yasso na sad guru padam buje. It is real. If you have no attraction for Guru Vaishnava, until unless you are having tremendous attraction unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, you cannot come out successful. Srinivasacharya is speaking that way. So, Rupa Goswami, one time at the bank of Jamuna in Bhajan Kutir, there Rupa Pad writing Rasamrita Sindhu. At the same time, Vallabh Bhatta coming here. What book you are reading? I paid on. You coming? Because before you can remember, Rupa Pad got the chance to go at his home, Arayal Gram, with Mahaprabhu. When Mahaprabhu went to Varanasi, Allahabad, you can remember. That time, Allahabad, Ballavata is big. He's not a simple man. So, what book you are writing? Actually, it is with humble Rasamrita Sindhu I am writing, trying to write. So, okay, I can write some rectification note on that. If there is any mistake, I can rectify. Sangshodhan. In Sanskrit or Bengali, you say Sangshodhan. My rectification I can do. Proofreading and Siddhanta mistake I can do. Jivapad was watching. How that man speaking that way? After that, that man gone, Vallabh Bhatta gone to take bath in Jamuna, and Jiva Goswami Pad playing this hand fan. Now Jiva Pad asking, Prabhu, can I go to Jamuna? Why? There's water I need actually. Actually I need water, because drinking water. Okay, you can go. When gone, but their main reason was there to follow him. With Picha gone, with water pot, gone there and following him. And very humble mood. If you never mind, I have one question. What mistake you have seen in the writings of my Gurudev so that you told that I can rectify? What mistake? Then you was stopped. A small boy singing this way. After that, then Shastra Vichar. He is speaking Siddhanta, he is speaking Siddhanta, he is speaking Siddhanta. Then Vallabh Bhatta gone mad. This small boy, what kind of proficiency, what deep knowledge. Oh my God. He was bound to stop. This puzzle. Now after taking bath, again Vallabh Bhatta coming back to Rupa Goswami Pad. And asking, who is that boy who is playing hand fan on you? Actually, what to speak, he is my actually nephew. Purva Ashram, previous Ashram. No, actually my disciple, you can say that way. Oh, really? Gone, not speaking anything. And then Rupa Jiva Goswami Pad coming back. Because Rupa Goswami Pad realized everything. Because Vallabha Bhatta was bound to speak, you need not rectify that book. It's okay. Why speaking just a few minutes before speaking, I can rectify your book. Now speaking, no need of rectification, it's okay. I can go. The Rupa Bhatta could realize, hey, where are you gone? To take water. Speak rightly. You couldn't bear. He is senior to me. He wants to rectify my books. He couldn't bear this much. Better you can go away from me. I don't like to see your face. You have not that kind of tolerance you don't have. He is senior to me. He is showing compassion to me. He wants to rectify my books. What's wrong in it? He couldn't bear it. Go away from me. I don't like to see your face. Right now you go away. Then Jiva Bhatta crying and gone. Where to go? Without Gurudev we have no shelter. Where to go? Crying and crying. No prasadam, no water. Ultimately gone. I am doing 84 parikrama. 84 parikrama. Then we are bound to go. Baigaon. One place is there. That name is Baigaon. Baigaon mean? Nanda Maharaj was abducted by the servant of Varun Deva, that place. That place name is Baigaon. Because Nanda Maharaj cried, Nanda Maharaj couldn't understand the proper timing. After Ekadasi, so I thought maybe I can sit and do bhajan, so better now I can go to Jamuna. That time was not proper time. At that time, the servant of Varun running here and there, they got Nanda Maharaj taking bath in Asuri Vela, took Nanda Maharaj and gone to down there in Varun Loka. And Nanda Maharaj crying, Krishna, save me. He was fearful. That's why the name of that place is Baigaon. Why mean? Fear. We go there. There Jiva Goswami Pad going, and those Brajavasis with great affection and love arrange one small cave, small bhajan kutir, and arranging water, and braids, and yogurt, milk, everything. But Jiva Bhatta not taking anything. Long time fasting, become slim. And it is written there that Jiva Goswami Pad got the chance to write Sandarbha and some important books also there that time, exclusively. That's and somehow it is the arrangement of Supreme Lord, Sanatana Goswami, Bade Baba, was bound to go there somehow in course of his traveling towards 84 course. Then they go, and those Vrajavas is crying, Baba, one small sadhu coming, a very young age, is not taking any prasadam water, only crying. Who, where? Is there? Very nice looking, and not taking any prasadam, only crying. Why? Where? Let me go there. Then Sanatana Goswami was expressing doubt. Who can be? Description? As per description, it must be Jeev. Then Sanatana Goswami reaching, who is Jeev? And Jiva Goswami started crying more big way, bursted into tears. Then Sanatana took in his lap, kissing him. What happens, my boy? This is the thing happened. You wanted to insult my Gurudev. I was bound to protect the honor of my Gurudev. It is Siddhanta. But my Gurudev speak, go away from me. I don't like to see your face anymore. Go! Wherever you like. Oh, that's why I'm helpless. I'm here. Come on with me. Come on with me. Who is there to drive you away? And with Sanatana Goswami Pad taking Jiva in hand and coming in front of Rupa Goswami Pad, keeping Jiva Goswami Pad backside. Then Sanatana, Rupa Goswami by paying dandavat to whom? To Sanatana, because Gurudev. And Gurudev speaking some special news to him. Jivedaya, it can be there in books. Eh? What do you mean? Jivedaya ki gronthatei thakve? Jivedaya ki philosophy thakve? In Bengali. Jivedaya, darshanik shabdota, ukhani thakve? Naki eta, what do you mean? I mean to say, Jivedaya, this word is an exhibition, or you will have to show. What do you mean? Where is Jiva? Oh, now understand, this is the reason. Heavy, heavy. Come, Jiva, come. Why you dive him away? Then pay dandavat. Please excuse me. After that, again seva. Jivapad was so powerful. Any books written by Sanatan Roop, they giving final correction to Jivapad. Can you imagine? Even Vallabhbhatta was conscious enough to understand. He wrote one book, Tattvadeep, Tattvadeep or Tattvapradeep, I forget, on Vedanta Sutra. He ultimately was bound to show this book to Jivapad. Jivapad going through this book and indicating there is some mistake. Vallabhbhatta. Jivapad giving indication, this is not this Vedanta Siddhanta, this judgment is not proper. You will have to change this. So final correction was done by whom? Jivapad. Now you think, whenever Sanatana writing, Jiv, Roop writing, Jiv, you can take trouble to rectify this. Now you can understand, you can feel, realize the position of, in the whole Vaishnava society, even still today, unbeaten, unparalleled. Jivapad is unbeaten, unparalleled. What to speak more? I have lot of things to speak, but time cannot permit. Time cannot permit. Sankha purvaka nama gananati bhi kala vasani krito. This look? This way they are leading life. We like to lead our life like king. This is a different. Yukta Vairagya, if you can understand under the guidance of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then we can protect this Vaishnava society. Or it's impossible. Impossible. Who can give protection? To whom? Nobody going to hear. At the time of Prabhupada, there was a system of Ekadasi, how to follow. Now he is making one Ekadasi, he is making one. So different. No unity. We wanted to see unity in diversity. And at present, we cannot find unity in diversity. That is a big problem. So, I like to stop here, my small speech. So I am begging Kripa from Jivapad to get a little bit Kripa, because I am not fit. So you can remember the sloka, usually all Guru Bhargava speaking. Nana sastha vichara naika nipuno sadharma sangsthapako lokanam hitakarino tibhubane manyo saranyakaru Radha Krishna Padar Binda Bhajana Nandina Mataliko Bande Rupa Sanatano Rugujugo Sijiva Gopalako Bande Rupa Sanatano Rugujugo Sijiva Gopalako Vanchakalpatarvasya Kepasindhi Bhavishya Patitanam Pavana Bhavishya